We are starting the much awaited program called as VIHASA. This will be purely an interactive program. To start, I would like to invite our very respected President of Medical Wing of Brahma Kumaris, Dr. Ashok Mehta ji, to please come onto the stage and take your seat. And I also invite Sister Rupa from Global Hospital Mount Abu and Sister Kalpana from Global Hospital to please come onto the stage and take your seats. And let's give a warm welcome to them. Let's show even if we are few, we can still welcome nicely. I also request Dr. Kiran Balaji, who has come from Delhi, who is a famous neurologist, to please come onto the stage and take your seat. Dr. Kiran Balaji. I request our sisters to please welcome our esteemed panelists, or I should say the felicitators of VIHASA program. Let's sit in God's remembrance for 3 minutes before we start the program. सभी से रिक्वेस्ट है जो पीछे बैठे हैं थोड़ा सा आगे आ जाए प्लीज कम फॉरवर्ड एंड टेक योर सीट्स बिकॉज ये एक इंटरैक्टिव प्रोग्राम होगा आपको बहुत सारी चीज़ें डिस्कस करनी है शेयर करनी है तो अगर आप पास में बैठेंगे तो अच्छा रहेगा तो जो पीछे हैं आगे आ जाइए थैंक यू सो मच And we will start this program now. VIHASA, Values in Healthcare, a Spiritual Approach. We just know the full form of this, but there are a lot more what is there under the VIHASA banner. And I request Dr. Ashok Mehta ji to please come and introduce us what is VIHASA, what are the various modules, and what we exactly do under this banner, and what are the services we have done so far, and the future services. Dr. Ashok Mehta ji, who is the president of Medical Wing, let's welcome him again. Thank you so much. And Dr. Mehta ke baare mein pehle bhi bataya hai ki he is a 87-year-old young man sitting in front of you. And I think the most energetic of us all, isn't it? And he's a renowned head and neck oncosurgeon who has worked in Tata Memorial Hospital, Nanavati Hospital, Leelavati Hospital, and BSES Hospital in Mumbai, and who is still practicing right now, who has conducted various CME and conferences all around the world. So I request Dr. Ashok Mehta ji to please give the introduction of VIHASA.
Om Shanti, and good evening to all of you. I'm going to present to you the values in healthcare, a spiritual approach, the acronym of VIHASA. This program is a unique program for personal and team development of healthcare professionals. This is a paradigm shift. Most of the time when we talk of any program, it's to improve the care, the treatment, and the outcome of treatment of the patients. Here we talk of the care of the caregiver, care of the healthcare professional, the doctor himself. It's one of the fundamental changes that you will bring about when you look at this program is that you have to take good care of yourself. And I think that's the essence. This program was developed by Janki Foundation of UK. Janki Foundation is named after Dadi Janki, whose picture you see in the in here. Dadi Janki was chief of Brahma Kumaris. Was chief of Brahma Kumaris between 2007 and 2020. She just passed away in 2020 at the ripe age of 104, and she was active till the end. Dadi Janki, we must pay a great tribute. She is the one who went to UK and London in 1974, and this was the first organized attempt of the Brahma Kumaris to establish their centers overseas. Dadi Janki did not speak English, but she was very intense yogi, and her yoga really worked. And when she passed away, we had centers in 140 countries of the world. That is the power of yoga. And Dadi Janki used to visit the hospitals in England and used to find that there was no khushi, unke pande khushi nahi thi. Itna acha kaam karte hue, doctors or nurses or aajubaju ke jo log the, unke jo khushi she noticed was lacking. And she wanted to do something to bring about the intense feeling of that you're doing a great work. And she asked the brothers and sisters in the center that we must develop some program for improving the value systems of the healthcare professionals. And end result was this program. As you can see, this is a big volume, almost 450 pages. This was developed by a group of 10 doctors, physiotherapists, healthcare professionals, and educational consultants, putting all their might together. We have noticed that there's a large component of burnout, compassion fatigue, and vicarious trauma amongst the healthcare professionals. Life of a doctor, it starts with the 10 years of education as a consultant, 10 years of education and training, almost 10 to 25 years of clinical experience, and in alleviating the pain and saving the lives. Yet, more than 40% burnout, even in our country. There is a study from All India Institute of Medical Sciences in Delhi, which said 40% burnout amongst the doctors in India. So let's have a look at our lives from a different viewpoint. This was the medical school where I went, to GS Medical College in Mumbai, one of the leading medical schools in those years. I entered the medical school in 1955. And our motto was non sibi sit omnibus, not for the self, but for the others. With that motto, this is how we, as young medical graduates, medical students, wanted to do our studies and life program. Were we taught anything in these colleges as far as the values was concerned? We most of the time picked up the values from the chiefs with whom we worked, the teachers from whom we learned our medicine, or from the hospital staff. And there was no systematic way of imparting values in our education. And all that we did was picked it up by the contact. In those years, every medical student or every graduate has his ideal. Many of them have the ideals of their teachers or their professors or their parents, grandparents, or maybe some national or international leaders. I had the vision of Mahatma Gandhi. As I shared with you the other day, I had read his book, My Experiments with Truth, when I was in school in the formative years, around 8 or 10 years of age. And I felt that I would like to follow the ideals of Mahatma Gandhi at that point of time. And here is a picture of Mahatma Gandhi treating the wound of a leprosy patient. He was a Sanskrit scholar. His name was Parchure Sastri. Parchure Sastri suffered from damaging effects of leprosy in those years when there were no cure. And his family turned him away from house, and he decided that he would go to Wardha, have darshan of Mahatma Gandhi before he passed away. And when he went to Wardha, he was not allowed to enter the ashram, but Gandhiji was informed that somebody wants to see you, and he was made to lie under a tree outside the ashram. When Gandhiji came and saw this Parchure Sastriji, he realized that this man was suffering from a contagious leprosy, but he wanted to take care of him. The man had come all the way to have his darshan, and he was taken in against the wishes of the ashramites, and he looked after the wounds, and he used to dress the wounds himself and massage the wounds. In those days, leprosy was a contagious disease, but this is what a compassionate care is. And the other picture is that of Dr. Albert Schweitzer. He was a Frenchman who went, he was a German, but he became a French national and went to Gabon, which is in Central Africa, to look after the very poor ailing patients. He felt that he received the Nobel Prize in 1952, and his theme was the care of, he was taking the blame of the whites having exploited the blacks. And that was his main theme. He was actually a musician and a pastor. And he changed his nationality because he wanted to serve the African poor patients. And till now, that is a famous hospital in Gabon, in his name, Albert Schweitzer. So these were my ideals at that point of time. I'm sure that all of you, when entered the medical school, had different ideals and different value systems that you promoted. We have been talking about the philosophy of Raja Yoga, and there are two words, who are we? And we always say we are human beings. Human stands for the soil, the five elements, which is going to return to its natural element. However, the being or the consciousness We have been talking about awareness of our spiritual identity for the last 2 days, and I'm sure that most of you are aware that who are we, who am I, what is my nature, and what am I supposed to do? The qualities of the soul we have discussed, you heard throughout the last 2 days, are mainly the seven qualities. In Hindi, you've been talking about Gyan, Pavitrata, and we have been always told that Pavitrata, Sukh or Shanti ki janani hai. And therefore, we are looking for happiness and peace, which results in Anand and Prem. And we have the powers. The powers, this is what we are going to talk about during this, power to face, to tolerate, and to withdraw. These are our major powers. As you will notice here, the concept of the soul is we have an internal system, internal world, which is made up of mind, intellect, and personality, or sanskars. The mind is the one which creates the thoughts, emotions, and desires, and the intellect is one which is a judging and discriminating or deciding power. Mind creates, as we have heard, 40 to 60,000 thoughts, and it's intellect which screens off the thoughts, and decides what thoughts should go into the words and action. And we convey to the outside world, we convey to the outside world our emotions, desires, and decision through the spoken words or through the action. And this, I think the major thing that we have been, that we should have the positive thinking. And this is our major contribution in the value system, that we must turn to positivity. This entire program is based on two very fundamental things. One is positivity, another is appreciative inquiry. Whatever we speak or do is recorded back in our system, in our personality, in our subconscious, as we've been hearing, and this becomes our memories, impressions, and also becomes our instincts all the time to come. And this value system depends on what we think. So it's very important that we give a lot of attention to make our mind peaceful, positive, and purposeful. The types of human values, we know that we are told, of course, this is not what we believe in this institution, but humans used to kill and satisfy hunger. There was a paradigm shift when we, from barbarism, we turned to live and let live. The values like peace, respect, tolerance, love, etc., we developed, and what contributed to the development of the values. The value system, as you see, depends on three things. We receive our initial values from our parents, our family. Second, we receive the value systems when we go to schools, colleges, when we are educated. And third, when we work in the society, we follow the norms of the society and the values that are followed. The types of values, normally we have been used to listen to moral values, which help to remain on, helps us remain on the right path, which are noble, elevated, to make us a noble, elevated human being, and deciding between what is right and what is wrong, and maintaining good relationships. The very important thing that we have to develop as physicians is patience and tolerance. The spiritual values is the one which we are talking about. This is the entire program has been to develop the spiritual values, to connect the self and the Supreme, and get the powers of the Supreme, get the virtues and values of the Supreme in our life, and that will identify our strength and maintain a balanced state of mind. The values are defined as the virtues which are acquired and developed through concentration of positive personality traits. The entire emphasis is on mind creating positive thoughts and not to have negative or waste thoughts. There are three beautiful words. One, when we say man, there's daman, aman and suman. Aman is to have no mind. Even a thought that I don't have a thought is not practical. And daman is something that's suppressing the mind. But we believe in suman, that is creating the positive, creative thoughts. We have been always told in the last 2 days that you must create a positive thought. My shaktishali atma hum, my vijayi atma hum, and so on. And therefore, I think this is what we need to create as healthcare professionals. Values are important principles of life that make our life and work valuable. We help understand the purpose of life. Why am I here in this world? Why have I become a doctor? What am I? Is it only the basic things? Is it for earning my livelihood, improving my personal and my family's wealth, or is it something higher than that? The personal truths are important for our happiness. I think all of us have certain visions of why we are working. As you will see that in this organization, Niswartha Seva, or selfless service, is one of the biggest motives. And I think all of us have deep inside those noble thoughts. There are values like hard work, the simplicity, the punctuality, discipline and positivity, dedication and respect. I think these are the values which all of us try to imbibe in our life. And these are the things most important are compassion and kindness, love and honesty, which will bring new vitality to our practice and help us rediscover our own personal values. Traditional training, as we take in the medical schools or even nursing schools or physiotherapy or dental schools, is something that does not increase our calmness and compassion. There's no guidance for enhancing these qualities of compassion and calmness. And this is what we impart through these values in healthcare program. It's most of the time, when we want to run this program of VIHASA, which is a personal and team development program for the institutions, we are told that there's not time, there's not enough financial benefits, and there's no desire. This doesn't increase the desire or status. And therefore, I think even if you want to give it free to institutions, most of the institutions are reluctant to have these programs in their institutions. This program consists of 8 modules. There's one introductory module which is on building resilience. You have been hearing the word resilience is bouncing back. From all of us, we go through the periods when the things are a little dark, we are disappointed, we are disheartened, and then we bounce back. And this building resilience is our introductory chapter. Then there are 7 other modules. Each module takes about 8 hours of the program. This program basically has 2 components. We introduce the program, and then we have 8 or 10 exercises. And each exercise is about bringing it in your personal life and in professional life, how it can change the value system. To understand the values, we have we often consider values as a tree of values, which is spiritual, strong, full impact on our personality. And then there is the module on peace, to bring peace to our practice. It is like a roots of a tree. It has a firm foundation which lays of the value system. Then the positivity, which is a trunk and is underlying the attitude and the strength of the tree. And the compassion module, which talks about it's like giving the fruits of myself, nurturing my value system. And there's a cooperation, valuing this yourself and spirituality. I think the valuing the yourself is one of the important messages we want to give, that all of us, we are working in a very stressful profession, and therefore, unless and until we take good care. And three things which we have been talking about is, one is the diet, another is exercises, and third is meditation. Meditation to look after your system, the mind, to make it peaceful. The diet and exercises to look after your physical health. The spirituality in healthcare is equal. This is the major issue that we have in the Brahma Kumaris, that we wanted to bring spirituality in their life, to bring in meditation, to bring in peace and positivity. And these are 7 modules, and introductory module on the resilience. The three key principles on which this program is based, the first and most important, physician, heal thyself. Are we feeling good? Are we enjoying our work? Are we surviving or thriving? These three questions we have to answer ourselves. And in this program, healthcare, as I said, there's a paradigm shift. Healthcare professional is at the center of the program. Self-care and personal development are very important. And it will restore the moral, restore the purpose, vision, and values by following this program of values in healthcare. We have reduced personal achievement and competence. 60% have unmanageable stress. They feel overworked and under-supported. There's a burnout. We have heard of frequent attempts at suicide by the healthcare professional. We develop negative attitudes and feeling towards the patients. And therefore, I think this is a very important principle. The second key principle is learning through the direct experience. We must understand values through the personal experience ourselves. What we do in this program, the group is normally between 15 to 20, not beyond 25. In other words, there's a one facilitator and one coordinator. And you have to have a very peaceful, nice, preferably an air-conditioned hall or air-conditioned room in which this program is carried out. This is a facilitated program. In other words, there's no lectures. The facilitator is one who facilitates. He introduces the program, he introduces the exercise, and then the participants, they work individually and in groups, in pairs. So we give time to reflect any question that's given. You spend a few minutes with yourself, look back within yourself, and then you share it with your partner. So this is the most important thing. Normally, whenever we are alone, we cannot think properly, or we cannot look back. But when you have to share it with someone, it becomes a very different ball game. And there's enough time for reflection, and then you share it in a supportive environment. This is an essential component of the values in healthcare, that there is a confidentiality. And initially the people have, there is a kind of, you are not open, but once you open up, then it's a lot of fun and a lot of expression of your own real self. So the learning through a direct experience is an essential component of this program. And the third component is it has, whatever you learn, it has to be relevant to your profession and your personal life. And you take it back and carry it in your clinic, in your home, and your interpersonal relationship. We plan action planning and evaluation of the program. How did it go? Then we are committed to ongoing learning. In other words, whatever the program you do on that particular group, that program can be extended at a later point of time. And there's a commitment to ongoing learning. The essence is a healing environment that we must create when you want to carry out a program like this. Now, for example, the benefits of being positive are at a physical level. We started this program initially at our own hospital in Mumbai in 2005. This program actually was developed between 2000 and 2004 in England. Pilot projects were done and finally launched in 2005 in UK. At the same time, it was launched in India. I had the privilege to be in the initial group. And at that point, I was a director of the Brahma Kumaris Global Hospital in Mumbai. And we had this program done on our own staff. It changed our entire environment of the hospital. We started knowing the dormant talents amongst the people. There were more personal interrelationship, and there were no barriers. The barriers were broken, and we started working more as a team. It was more beneficial in terms even in creating a very jovial and beautiful atmosphere in the hospital itself. So at physical level, it increased our energy, added to our recovery. There was an increase in self-esteem. Things appeared to make easier. Socially, we had a better interrelationship. Spiritually, it increases the capacity to be hopeful. That was a positivity that we developed. It had a, valuing the self had a positive impact on others around, that means on the staff and on the patients itself. We use seven spiritual tools for doing this program. If you want to do any program, you must have the tools. Here we use seven spiritual tools. You have been talking about meditation. This is our most important goal, to quieten and focus our mind through the meditation. You have heard enough in the last 48 hours. I don't need to go through the whole thing, but it directs thoughts to the desired state of feeling, to feel positive, to feel peaceful, to feel powerful, and also being calm and contented and happy, and becoming more accepting and less angry. I think most of the time the trouble starts because we have a kind of feeling that somebody insulted you. I think that's the thing that we must take out of our systems through our meditation. The reflection is second tool, which is actually reflecting on the positive things that you have done in your life, lessons from past experience, taking a detached view of the situation. Reflection is nothing else but looking yourself in the mirror. Here you are looking back within yourself. So stand back and look at yourself from outside. You have done whatever you have, say for example, what are the successes that you achieved in your life? And what was the cause for your success? You look back at yourself. Examine the emotional reactions and feelings that you had at that point of time, how to be calm and observe what has happened. I think reflection is a very important tool. For example, if you're going to treat a difficult patient, whether you're going to operate or treat, you will look back at yourself. how beautifully or successfully you have done similar patients in the past. That gives you a kind of added confidence that you're going to do it very well. It also strengthens your self-esteem and it builds your positive experiences. Build on your positive experiences. This I've seen repeatedly. When I had a difficult patient to operate, I know that I have been successful. If I sit quietly, peacefully, and look back, okay, we have succeeded, and therefore there's nothing to worry about. Remember the things that have gone well. Most of the time what happens is, every time you see something difficult, you always think of a failure. We don't think of a failure, but think positively about where you succeeded. That gives you added confidence in yourself. Another thing is visualization, to create a mental images, positive images, using creativity and intuition. Sights, sounds, these are our gnanendriyas, that we have those beautiful views we can create, visualization, and this is what we use most of the time in these programs. Deep listening, we have heard about this deep listening, is a most important aspect of communication, especially we have to do with the patients or their relatives. We must give the full attention, deep listening at a spiritual tool, and it's a healing effect on the patient and relieve the suffering. Another thing is appreciation. We have actually Healthcare Professional Appreciation Day on May 28th. Appreciation, people work better. The entire program is based on appreciative inquiry. The last two, the creativity and play, are very important from point of view of doctors. We have forgotten that there is we can be childlike all over again. We can sit down, we can play, we can paint, we can do this in a group. This is what we have done, that most of the time the doctors are left-sided, rational, logical, and scientific. But we neglect our intuitive, poetic, and creative part of the right brain. And working in groups together, when we work together, this can be very creative. We create skits, we create small dramas, we do the paintings. These are some of the exercises are on this creativity and play. I think this is an essential component of values in healthcare, a spiritual approach. Here you can see the people doing the cuttings and creating some posters and banners. And here you can see them playing amongst themselves, creating skits, creating dramas, and dancing. You have experienced that yesterday when Dr. Prem presented his work with exercises. And I think creativity and play should be a big contribution in valuing ourselves in a value system. I think what it does is it brings your right brain into play. The atmosphere becomes very light. You start enjoying working together. The fun and laughter balances the serious discussion and deep reflection. It opens our hearts and brings groups together as a spontaneous, carefree, and letting go of the barriers. Say, for example, if you're head of department and your other members of the staff, probably you'll break the barrier. Otherwise, you'll be considering somebody as a chief and somebody as an associate. This is very important. You wouldn't let this. Most of the time, our batteries, as we have been talking, is a self-care is a priority and not a luxury, because our batteries are running low. Our powers are going to run down, and therefore it's very important that we should take care of ourselves and recharge our batteries. Giving self-care is a priority, is not a luxury. I think this is a message that we would like to give. Only when we care for ourselves can we also care for others. We have made several attempts to introduce this program in the universities, in the medical schools and in the associations. There have been a great response. We had a Vice Chancellor of Maharashtra University of Health Sciences, Dr. Arun Jamkar. Between 2015 and 2020, he wanted to introduce this program for all undergraduates in all the medical schools. We have, at that point, we had almost more than 350 medical colleges, nursing colleges, physiotherapy colleges in Maharashtra. We had presented this to the Vice Chancellor's Conference in Lucknow, where the 14 medical university vice chancellors were there. We had also presented to the academicians and executive committee in Nasik. And we ran this program for the university in Nasik. This program is being run in several places, but this is requiring, at least you must have 7 to 8 days to take this whole program to the staff. It should be taken basically to the undergraduate and postgraduate students, or even those who are in practice, but you must spare those 8 days. That's essential. People want to do the program in 2 hours, 1 hour, it's not practical. You want to bring the positivity, you want to bring about a change at the level of the mind, at a deeper level, at the internally, then you must make the effort through this kind of a program. This is a unique program. I don't think there's any program similar to that for bringing value system to our profession, and especially to prevent the burnout. We have, during the COVID time, we realized that it was not practical to have this kind of programs because we were not allowed to meet in groups. And therefore, we tried to develop VIHASA Online. And this VIHASA Online program was developed at during the COVID time. We used to have an Australian brother, his name was Stephen. He conducted the first session of VIHASA facilitator from India in April 5, 2020. And then overall, the 80 sessions were conducted by some of our colleagues. And this conceptualizing the structural training program on online, so we decided to form a VIHASA Online project. This was subsequently taken up by the Janaki Foundation in 2022 from UK. And this VIHASA India Online was formed, growing team of about, we have 20 online trained facilitators, 4 regional coordinators, and we have a monthly Zoom sessions between January and August every month to help familiarize with the platform and connect with the fellow online facilitators. This online VIHASA is not the same as offline. I think offline is a much, much intense, requires more time, but it is more productive. However, we have now 4 regional coordinators. We have trained about 20 online facilitators. And in future plan, we are creating an online forum for trained facilitators, learning community, which will continue with quarterly meetings and sustaining the learning community. In-person and online retreats will be organized. This is a very, I would say, promising program, because it can be done economically and it can be done online. This is how it works on Zoom. Online, both are, as I said, both are completely different and different time of trading. We have, if anyone wants to know, you can connect with the VIHASA India Online on this email, Gmail, and in person on VIHASAIndia@gmail.com. As we've been talking, learning meditation is free at all the Brahma Kumari centers. You can benefit by meditation to have a peaceful, positive attitude and putting the heart into the healing. All that I would like to say is the VIHASA is a very exciting program. Those of you who have interest, you can contact some of us here through the emails I've talked about, and we can conduct this program in your institutions. We have almost 200 trainees who will come to your institution and provide all the training. The only thing that is demanding is it requires time. You must have 8 hours. You must have the infrastructure. You cannot do it in a classroom style. You cannot lecture. It has to have arrangements in which you have enough space for movement, enough space for working. You have to provide all the materials for creative work. So those of you who have interest, you can certainly contact us. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ashok Mehtaji, for this elaborate and comprehensive introduction of VIHASA, what we do under this program. And now over to Sister Rupa and Sister Kalpana ji for the next activity, that is icebreaker.
Om Shanti. Om Shanti. Abhi aap logon ne sabhi ne suna. The beauty of this program is only first introductory session. After that, there is all are the interactive sessions are there. So now we can start with the small exercise. It's called a ice break. So you have to make your pairs. Aise pairs banao ki jinko aap jante nahi hai. Aur unko aapko sirf 4 questions banane hai. Aap pairs banayenge ek dusre ko. Aur aise ki jinko aap jante nahi hai, pehli baari aap mil rahe hai. बना सकते हैं ऐसे पेयर्स आप लोग प्लीज़ आप लोगों को उठना होगा पेयर्स बनाइए जिनको आप जानते नहीं हैं अगर आप जानते हैं तो नहीं जिसको आप जानते नहीं हैं और आपको 4 क्वेश्चंस पूछने हैं सिर्फ 4 क्वेश्चंस आप ध्यान दीजिए एक तो नाम है कि पहली बार आप मिल रहे हैं इसलिए नाम पूछेंगे कि नाम क्या है What is speciality? आप लोगों की speciality क्या है? Third is कि what values you practice in your daily life? Daily life में आप कौन से values को use करते हैं? जो आपकी values है? And fourth is कि कौन सा animal या bird? Animal या bird आपको अच्छा लगता है और वो क्यों अच्छा लगता है? 4 चीजें. Only 4 questions you have to ask. Name स्पेशलिटी आप लोगों की जो भी स्पेशलिटी है थर्ड इज योर वैल्यूज यू आर प्रैक्टिसिंग इन योर डेली लाइफ एंड फोर्थ इज अ एनिमल और बर्ड एंड व्हाई यू लाइक दैट एनिमल व्हाट कॉल इट एनिमल और बर्ड बर्ड और एनिमल
व्हिच एनिमल डू यू लाइक द मोस्ट एन एनिमल
एंड योर फेवरेट एनिमल ओके जस्ट मेक अ पेयर्स Sister Minoti, please help to make a pairs.
Rashmi.
Brothers, please make a pair. Sir, please. With pairs, you have to ask these questions.
आप अब आपस में बातें कर रहे हैं Good. हाँ
So, hope.
Name,
okay.
Speciality,
name, speciality,
values I practice in my life, and an animal I like, or a bird. Name, speciality, animal, and a value I practice in my life. You also can make a pair. You have done? Who is your pair? Achha.
You have a pair?
Okay.
हो गया आप लोगों का हो गया पोत्रो हाँ वेर इज योर पेयर
Okay. Now, yes. So now, you might have finished the introduction. Wonderful. We will invite few pairs to share their partner's introduction. So you can volunteer, Please come. And the volunteers will be handing you over the mic. Rashmi, mic hai niche? Ye le lijiye.
Brother, we need a mic downstairs in the audience.
One pair can come here. Ab ho gaya? What are we supposed to do? Share karne ke liye aa jana.
And she will introduce
unke baad. One thing you have to share of your partners.
Yeah. Okay, she is Jigisha and she's an anesthesiologist from Rajkot. She's an associate professor and she is kind and loving and she has, she likes peacock.
Hello, she is Manisha Bansal from Bijlani from Pune. She's also an anesthesiologist.
Okay, I sister, just one second. I request all of you to please stop the sharing. Please stop the sharing because we have our doctors sharing what you have already discussed with each other. So please come back to your seat. Please come back to your seat. Mm-hmm. I know you like to talk to each other so much. Yes, sister, you can start.
She is Manisha. She is from Pune. She is also an anesthesiologist. And she is doing freelancing practice. She like parrot. She is kind and loving.
Parrot. And values, which values you are practicing? Kind and loving. And you are? Same. Okay.
Rashmi.
Pratis, you can start.
He is a Pankaj Suryavanshi from Nashik, Maharashtra. He is an anesthetist. He is punctuality, hard work and honesty. And punctuality.
And punctuality he like, and honesty.
Honest. And he like animal dog because he is a very honest to the with everyone.
Master. With honest to
being.
The master.
Yeah.
Loyal and honest.
Loyal.
Okay.
He is Dr. Sandeep Pol from Satara. And his values are for his families. He cares for his families and his staff members, and he also cares for does a very ethical practice. And his favorite animal is also dog.
Dog.
Yeah.
Okay. Now the another pair. One more pair from that side.
This is Dr. Pratiksha. She is from Wardha. Her specialization is in dermatology. Her values in life are sincerity and dedication towards family as well as her profession. And the animal she loves is dog because it is loving and loyal.
My partner is Dr. Snehalata Manudhane. She's a pediatrician. The value she has in her life is she is compassionate and truthful. The animal she loves is a dog because they love unconditionally.
Dog, compassion, and?
Compassion, it loves unconditionally.
Unconditional love. Wonderful, thank you. Vihan, would you like to share?
She is Dr. Kalpana from Nasik, Maharashtra. She is BAMS doctor and she uses honesty as values in her practice, and the animal she likes is cat.
And why she likes the cat? Because of what values she sees in cat?
Cat mere ko bahut matlab bahut acha lagta hai mera aisa ek unse kya bolte hai हाँ नहीं 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 बाकी तो नहीं कुछ पर ऐसा बहुत कि अभी हम नए बंगलों में शिफ्ट हो गए ना वहाँ पे एक आ जाता था तो मेरे यहाँ तक चढ़ जाता है ऐसा एक बच्चा कैसा अपने माँ को करता है इतना प्यार मेरे को करता है लविंग
हाँ लव लव
Madam is Dr. Nireza from Lucknow. He's gynecologist. And he compassion and empathy. And or unko fish bahut pasand hai.
Compassion, empathy, and peace.
Yes.
Animal?
Fish
hmm. pasand hai, values? Huh.
Because seeing the fish is like a meditation for me.
Seeing fish is like
watching the fish in my aquarium is like is like a meditation for
meditation
me.
Yes. Meditation, like.
Good evening, everyone.
You can face the audience.
Yes. My partner is Dr. Nihar Bhattacharya. He's from Calcutta, and he's a specialist in diabetes and thyroid. Values he practice in life is he uses the evidence-based medicine. He's up to date in his medical career. He uses economical in his practice. He uses the healing process while treating the patients, and he's empathetic towards his patients. Animals which he likes is cat, as he says that she's very loyal and she's always waiting for his return whenever he go to the clinic.
Yeah, my friend, he is Dr. A. Deshmukh from Baroda. He is an assistant pathologist, and values in life is he is very sincere, he is hardworking, he is honest and dedicated, and he is very prompt in delivering reports to his patients who come from far off places to his clinic. And the bird he likes is very interesting, peacock.
Peacock. The bird he likes is peacock. And why? What are the values?
He say or I should?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are the values you identify in peacock?
I feel it's a very calm bird, the beautiful bird with the colorful bird, and I like the calmness which the bird is having.
Calmness. Okay. So we will just conclude here. Aww. Yeah. Because we have, okay, one more.
Good evening, everyone. My partner is Dr. Purunita from Nepal. She is an anesthesiologist and an assistant professor. She likes the bird pigeon because that is a symbol of peace. And her values are she is helpful, polite, compassionate, and has acceptance to the problems of others.
Wonderful.
My partner is Dr. Pragati. She is a professor in ophthalmology. The values she practices are, she speaks polite, she tries to give smile to her colleagues and try to comply with others. And the animal she likes is horse because it represents strength and fast, it is fast. So she likes horse.
Thank you very much. We will just conclude this short exercise. This is called ice breaking. Do you feel that ice has
Next
broken?
Exercise is there.
Okay. So हमने देखा कि
इस values in health care or spiritual approach, this is a full form of the VIHASA. Values in health care a spiritual approach, the VIHASA is a short form for that we are calling, but full form is this.
So इस छोटी सी एक्सरसाइज में हमने जो वैल्यूज आइडेंटिफाई किए हमारे ग्रुप के वो है काइंडनेस, लव, ऑनेस्टी, पंक्चुअलिटी, लॉयल्टी, केयर, पीस, सिंसियरिटी, डेडिकेशन, फेथफुलनेस, अनकंडीशनल लव, ग्रैटिट्यूड, रिलैक्सेशन. बहुत सारे वैल्यूज आपने आइडेंटिफाई किए. आप देख रहे हैं कि खुद में जब आप काम करते हैं या पर्सनल लाइफ जीते हैं कुछ न कुछ वैल्यूज आप यूज़ करते हैं बट आइडेंटिफाई नहीं कर पाते हैं. आज जब हमने प्रश्न पूछा तब आपको महसूस हुआ कि हाँ ये वैल्यू मैं प्रैक्टिस करती हूँ, है ना. और एनिमल पूछने का पर्पस क्या था कि कौन सा एनिमल आपको अच्छा लगता है, ये पूछने का पर्पस क्या था. उनमें वैल्यूज देखना है. एनिमल्स के प्रति हमारा क्या होना चाहिए, लव, एक्सेप्टेंस. कई बार हम उनको इग्नोर करते हैं लेकिन ऐसे देखा गया है कि वो ही ग्रेटेस्ट हीलर्स होते हैं. चाहे आप गाय देख लीजिए, डॉग्स देख लीजिए, कैट्स देख लीजिए, बीमार व्यक्ति के आसपास हो तो वो एक हीलिंग का काम करते हैं. तो एनिमल्स के प्रति भी हमारा जो चाहिए एम्पथी, प्यार, वो हम एक्सप्रेस कर पाए या फील कर पाए, इसलिए ये एक्सरसाइज था. तो अब आइस ब्रेक हो गया, अब मैं इनवाइट करती हूँ डॉक्टर किरण बाला जी. रूपा बहन कुछ कहना चाहिए?
इस एक्सरसाइज में हमने कौन सा टूल यूज़ किया?
हाँ, वेरी
जो टूल, 7 टूल्स हमने देखे है स्पिरिचुअल टूल्स, तो इस एक्सरसाइज में कौन सा टूल यूज़ हुआ आप लोगों का? Listening. एक दूसरे को लिसन किया आपने, तो लिसनिंग टूल हमारा इसमें यूज हुआ.
एंड दूसरा टूल एप्रिसिएशन, हमने एप्रिसिएट भी किया, है ना? ओके, थैंक यू डॉक्टर रीना एंड डॉक्टर किरण बाला. अब आगे की एक्सरसाइज लेंगे.
थैंक यू सो मच. And now we move on to our next exercise, and the title of this exercise, which myself and Dr. Kiran Bala would be doing together, is High Point in My Working Life. तो आपको थोड़ा सा reflection करना होगा उसमें. हम instruction बहुत clearly देंगे. आपको ये जो professional life है, जो working life है, you have to recall a moment in your working life जो आपके जीवन में एक बहुत बड़ा achievement था. Means there was a situation and you achieved so much. Aapko bahut bada success mila. That was a very high working point in your professional life. Aapko wo scenario, wo incident recall karna hai. Jab aapne bahut badi achievement prapt ki, bahut bada success prapt kiya apni professional life mein. So there are two questions. First question is this. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन मैं इसके रिफ्लेक्शन के बाद आपको बताऊंगी. सो टेक योर 2 मिनट्स, रिकॉल दैट सिनेरियो इन योर माइंड. क्लोज योर आईज, सिट स्ट्रेट, रिकॉल दैट सिनेरियो इन योर प्रोफेशनल लाइफ जहां पर आपने बहुत काबिलियत को प्राप्त किया, बहुत सक्सेस मिली आपको, एक बहुत बड़ा अचीवमेंट था आपकी लाइफ में, आपकी प्रोफेशनल लाइफ में. Just keep on recalling that one major incident. And now the second question. Now when you have recalled that incident, आप identify करें अपनी उस predominant quality को जिस कारण से आपको वो बहुत बड़ा achievement मिला. Identify and explore that predominant quality which is there in your personality. You used it and was the responsible quality which helped you gain that major achievement and success. Take 2-3 minutes more and identify that quality. और अगर एक से ज्यादा क्वालिटी मिले तो वो भी आप आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं.
We all have something unique in ourselves which gives us strength to achieve great things, sometimes which appear unachievable or very difficult, very tough. We'll share, just wait. Everybody's done it? So we'll share with the group. You can raise your hand and I'll call one by one. You can have this mic.
We need to have mic in the audience. Rashmi Ben, we have?
Yes.
Yes. Shall I?
Yeah, sure.
What was that incident and what you feel made you achieve that?
Yes, yes. Yes. I am Dr. Venkatesa Rao. I am a pediatrician. Completed 31 years of my practice in pediatrics.
Please be brief because we are short of time. Yes. We have next session.
I had one case. That baby is a 3 years old child. Came to the hospital in odd hour. Morning 8:30 like that time. By the time I came from the exercise, by the time also, accidentally my intensivist also was there. So the baby brought to the hospital is in gasping. Baby is in gasping. So inquired the hospital, I mean parents, what happened? Sir, today morning only he sent his father because he is going to US. While returning back to the house and he was playing and suddenly became blue and gasping. So at that time now, we don't have any other choice. Ventilated the baby, but with difficult ventilation. We were unable to ventilate the positive ventilation also. So at that time we thought could be a foreign body. So immediately...
Kindly be brief. You.
Yes, yes. It is a foreign body we thought because there is no history of any foreign body from the parent side. So immediately we called bronchoscopist and we did the bronchoscopy. We identified a foreign body and removed that foreign body. But a father is in the flight, baby is in the hospital. So that was the situation. At that time we thought God is there to save that baby because intensivist and myself was there in the casualty at that point of time.
Very nice.
Thank
what
you.
Value you think you've had in yourself which is reflected in this?
Because that the situation itself is
your own value.
I could not understand your question.
Aapne aisi kya, your own value which made you achieve this success, your thought process and your prompt action.
Yes, that prompt action and concern
the
about the...
The value which you...
The concern about the child. Because at that time, no, that baby was refused twice from the different hospitals. Because the child is in gasping. Because I took the challenge as a...
Yeah.
So to save that baby. So
thank
that,
you so much.
Thank you.
So I have a small question. Ki the audience jo yahan baithi hai, aap help kar sakte hain ki... सर की कौन सी एक क्वालिटी थी? डिसीजन मेकिंग, करेज एंड एम्पैथी, प्रैक्टिकल सिनेरियो. ओके.
हेलो.
नेक्स्ट प्लीज मैम.
मैडम मैं.
सॉरी.
एंड गुड इवनिंग.
नेक्स्ट आफ्टर
डॉक्टर शैली कटियार.
सॉरी. After him.
मैं एक आत्मा हूँ और इस आत्मा का नाम डॉक्टर दयाराम स्वामी है. मैं पेशे से साइकेट्रिस्ट हूँ. एक बार एक पेशेंट का फ़ोन आया रात को मेरे पास 12 बजे और उसने कहा कि डॉक्टर साहब मैं सुसाइड करने जा रहा हूँ. उसने फंदा लगा लिया और आकर के पूरी तैयारी कर ली. मैंने उसको कॉल किया, उसको बातचीत की उससे. मैंने कहा भाई तुम ऐसा क्यों कर रहे हो, तुम्हारे परिवार है, बच्चे हैं, ऐसी क्या समस्या है, उसका अपन समाधान करेंगे, तुम ऐसा कदम मत उठाओ. मैंने उससे प्यार से बात की, 10-15 मिनट बात की. उसके बाद में उसका मानस बदल गया, उसका परिवार के भी वहाँ आ गए और उसने जो है वो आइडिया छोड़ दिया. फिर उस पेशेंट को लेकर के वो मेरे पास आए दूसरे दिन. मैंने उसका ट्रीटमेंट किया, वो ठीक हो गया. उसको मैंने रिहेबिलिटेट किया. मेरे नॉन डॉक्टर थे, उनके नर्सिंग स्टाफ वहाँ उसमें उसको एम्प्लॉय किया और वो अभी आराम से खुशी से जी रहा है. नहीं तो उस दिन उसका जीवन समाप्त हो जाता, उसका परिवार खत्म हो जाता.
सो व्हाट वैल्यूज यू हैड रिफ्लेक्टेड इन अचीविंग दिस? सॉरी, व्हाट वैल्यूज आर रिफ्लेक्टेड?
आई वॉज एम्पैथेटिक टू द पेशेंट, नॉट सिंपैथेटिक, एम्पैथेटिक. And
empathy?
I was, and I was soft spoken to him. I have used very simple words, very sweet words, सो ही लिसन्ड मी, अदरवाइज मैं अगर उसको कुछ और कुछ बोलता तो शायद वो मेरी बात नहीं सुनता, मगर मेरे प्यार से बोलने से वो काफ़ी सुना, और 10-15 मिनट सुनने के बाद में उसके परिजन भी आ गए और उसने आइडिया भी ड्रॉप कर दिया.
थैंक यू सो मच. एंड ऑन दिस नोट आई शुड टेल टुडे इज सुसाइड प्रिवेंशन डे, सो दैट्स अ वंडरफुल थिंग. एंड थैंक यू सर फॉर इनुमरेटिंग दिस सिनेरियो.
I'm Dr. Shelly Kutiyal. I'm a gynecologist from Delhi. I remember during my chief residency in Holy Family Hospital, we had two type of patients, private and general. So one of the general patients, when she delivered, she had retained placenta. All her relatives had run away, and then she needed blood immediately. Without giving a thought, I just went up. We had a blood bank, donated blood. Somehow the blood bank also quickly sort of gave me back that blood, went to the OT, did her MRP with my blood running, and it was just such a natural thing that I didn't think it was such a great thing. Next day in the hospital, the director called me, and like they were so grateful that how did you just think of it instead of, you know, making, going to another blood bank or something. So I felt good about it, because just now when you said, I remembered this.
The values you connect.
I felt this. My duty to my patient, and selflessness, and just, I mean, it was so spontaneous. I didn't waste any time.
Selfless care.
Yes.
Kindness. Thank you. Just one last sharing.
Right. 2015, ESD MacGregor Scholarship for Diabetes. I applied for that. It was a very tough competition. Ultimately, I got a call from them, and that I was selected. I went there. It was a wonderful feeling. And the values I find is that I am a clinician. I have my own clinic, and I am the only person sitting over there. That was the value they collected, because my record keeping, data, all those things, they cannot think of this kind of service for last 30 years. That means the value is the persistence, record keeping, data.
Record documentation.
Documentation.
And your devotion to your work.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. So what we have noticed is, sorry, we are running short of time. I know all of you have very, very good experiences. Everybody would like to share. As doctors, we are more focusing on our faults and our, we are always thinking that we could have done better, we should have done better. But see, when you reflect, you find that you do wonderful things. You have lot of good values, capabilities in you. So the values which we have come out with your sharing is faith, empathy, soft speaking, love, concern, help, sincerity, kindness, courage, compassion, taking responsibility, skill, persistence, devotion, decision making, and presence of mind. Thank you so much for wonderful sharing. And now I'll invite Sister Rashmi. She'll give you a moment exercise and make you physically active.
So we need some volunteers here. Aap mein se bhi kuch do log aage aa jaye. Aur Sister Rashmi stage pe karayengi movement exercise, and some of you can come in the front. And Manisha Ben, if he's here, she can also come onto the stage and join us. Manisha Ben. So before Rashmi starts, I want to ask you, what did you learn from this exercise? High working point in my professional life, isse humne kya sikha? Kya sikha? Before the music starts, what did we learn from this exercise? Reflection. Aur kya sikha? ये जो इतनी लंबी लिस्ट बनी है जो डॉक्टर किरण बालाजी ने इन्यूमरेट की, ये सारी वैल्यूज ऑलरेडी किसके अंदर थी? हमारे अंदर थी, और हम इसको यूज भी कर चुके हैं. इट वॉज जस्ट अ रिमाइंडर, अ वेरी नाइस रिमाइंडर टू ईच वन ऑफ अस. रश्मि बेन, शैल वी स्टार्ट? प्लीज.
प्लीज जो पीछे बैठे हैं वो प्लीज यहाँ आ जाए आगे, सो दैट जो थोड़ा ही इकट्ठे रहेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा रहेंगे। सभी खड़े हो जाए अपनी जगह पे, स्ट्रेच योर सेल्फ, स्ट्रेच।
मनीषा बेन प्लीज ज्वाइन अस, डॉक्टर गौरव भाई प्लीज ज्वाइन अस, डॉक्टर मोनिका खत्री इफ शी इज अराउंड प्लीज ज्वाइन अस।
ओके वी विल स्टार्ट।
Rashmi Ben, thank you so much.
I think you have had an example of the effectivity of creativity in play. You have had also, you know, reflections on what you could achieve. For such a large group in a large auditorium, probably is not an ideal situation, but you have had an example of how this program can break barriers, can bring a lot of joy to yourself and look within yourself. I think this program can bring a lot of positivity, appreciative of your own self. Most of the time we don't appreciate ourselves. I think valuing yourself is most important, and that also would help in improving your self-confidence, self-esteem. Most of the time we lose our self-esteem. We always think that we are inferior to somebody. I think we are the best example because you are the best creation of him. So I hope that you have an opportunity. When you work for the whole day together in a group, you create a lot of energy within your group and you develop a lot of confidence in each other. I think this is a program which can improve a lot of our self-care. I hope you have an opportunity of doing this for all the modules. This is only a minuscule example that you have had. Exercises are very interesting, and I think many of us can do a lot of good to ourselves. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And Dr. Mehta is right. See, if a movie is released, we show a trailer. This is not even a trailer of VIHASA. Trailer में at least movie का पूरा दिखाते हैं, लेकिन जो आपके सामने हमने इस डेढ़ घंटे में दिखाया है, ये तो trailer जितना भी नहीं है. You can imagine, it must be so beautiful. So you can opt to organize such programs at your place, and Dr. Mehta has shared all the email IDs, and we shall suffice this program with a beautiful meditation which Sister Kalpana will be conducting.
We also have the books here. Yeah, book, the entire pack.
Sir.
This is a whole volume which has all the exercises and how to conduct yourself. You don't have to use much of your talents. You know, all that you follow the book and you'll really enjoy it. Thank you. This book is available if you want to buy, but otherwise it's online free.
Online free. Yeah. You can just go to the website and you will find the book. Otherwise, if you want the paper copy, we have few books backstage. You can purchase.
They are obsolete because nobody uses CDs, but they are all meditations inside. So, you know, when you want to make a commentary of the meditation, it is there. How to conduct facilitation, all techniques are shown in this. How to create a group energy together, how to carry out this in your practice at a later point, is all. Everything is written down. You don't have to use anything. It's one of the finest manuals you can ever have. This took 4 years, more than 10,000 hours to create this program. So sometimes, you know, you have to have little patience and start working on it. You will enjoy it. Thank you.
If any one of you wants to become a facilitator for VIHASA, we are conducting programs for training programs also. You can get in touch with Sister Kalpana or Sister Rupa, or on email also. We post whenever, usually 2 or 3 training sessions are done in 1 year, so you can attend that also. But first, I think, as Dr. Mehta has said, we should try to organize programs at your institute, college, whatever, wherever you are working. So you get the real feel of it. It's just a glimpse which you have seen today. Thank you. It is ideally one day because it makes a flow. You start with one value, you learn about that value, then you start experiencing, then you go deeper, then you learn how to take it to your personal and your professional life. But if there is a time constraint, you can divide it also. But best would be to conduct it on one day. That should be a holiday, not a working day. You should be off from your work, totally free for the workshop. Usually we conduct it in small groups of maybe 20-25. Depends where it is being conducted. Sorry, nurses. Oh, any medical nurses, paramedical staff, anybody. Thank you. The module is in English. So it's better if the audience understands English. Here we are doing it in mixed. We are speaking Hindi also. Yeah. But yes, but you can explain in Hindi also. You are not audible.
As far as I understood, this total course consists of 7 modules of 8 hours each, or?
Yes, 8 hours each. So
each module is 8 hours, whole day.
Yes.
Because it's about 8 to 10 exercises you do. Each exercise takes about 25, 30 minutes, and some of them 45 minutes when they are creative. There are meditation commentaries which take about 10 minutes. So, you know, it's a all the 7 spiritual tools are used in
the whole module.
So the total course will be of 8 days?
Yeah, well, yes. It's like this. You can say, for example, we have an introductory module on resilience. It can be done in maybe in 2 to 3 hours. But otherwise, ideally, it should be 8 hours. People break it up. You can have half on one day, half on another day. But the ideal is, if you want to achieve a target, is 8 hours program. So and you require a good setup. You must have a hall, which is a space, say, about 25 by 30 feet with 20 chairs, which can be, you know, moved around. It can't be in an auditorium, fixed seats. No, yes, yes. You can't do that. And you must have a facility for lunch, facility for tea, washrooms. These are basic requirements. So it costs in terms of time and space. Okay. If you have institutions which have halls, then one can organize it. You require infrastructure, coordinating with people. You require papers, pencils, sketch pens, scissors, and all that kind of stuff to create posters and to create art.
So can we conduct these programs in the Indian Medical IMA halls? There are auditorium and also small halls there where we can practice for the spiritual things.
I think what we used to do in Mumbai, we had a REMI, that is a Reliance Electrics, had a hall. It's a management institution, which are nowadays lots of management institutions are there where they have these facilities all created. So sometimes you can get it for free for doctors, sometimes you have to pay for it. So, but otherwise it would cost about 8 to 10,000 rupees at least in carrying out this program for one day.
You are from Lucknow.
Lucknow. Yeah. So sure,
as Brahma Kumaris, we do not charge anything. For example, if we train someone or if we come to your institutions and carry it out, we don't take a penny.
Okay.
It's our service.
Logistics, you have to make local arrangement.
Okay.
For you make for any conference or workshop.
Yes, otherwise. Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think the next.
Okay. Now, this is the time for meditation and visualization. So, I will request all of you to sit upright, still it is little relaxed. Place your feet on the ground. Take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale, slow and steady. Feel your body. Feel your breath and go deep within. Feel the positive energy within. Remember the values you identified in your life, personal and professional. Think about one value which you practice in your life. Try to visualize a picture reflects through the value. So see the value in the form of the picture. Observe the colors of the picture. The beauty. If you can listen a sound, a soothing relaxing sound relating to that picture. Feel that value, the particular value you practice in your life, feel it. And now see yourself practicing that value at your workplace with your patients. Sense the feelings when you use and practice that value at your workplace. How do you feel? And what your patients feel in return? The exchange of energies. Feel that. Between a caregiver and a taker. Slowly come back to this place. And feel yourself sitting here and experiencing personal value. How do you feel sitting here when you think about the value? Slowly move your hands and legs a bit. Feel yourself relax. If you have closed the eyes, open your eyes. Take your time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and we have respected Dr. Banarsi Bhaiji among us for the next program, next session. You all know Dr. Banarsi Bhaiji, who is the Secretary of Medical Wing, and much thanks and gratitude to Dr. Ashok Mehta, Sister Kalpana, Sister Rupa, and Dr. Kiran Balaji. Thank you so much. Thank you.